First, I would like to thank Mark, Dan, and others at BioRelate for organizing this conference series and welcoming me to present. I'm really glad to be here sharing our work with you. Today, I'm going to summarize our efforts for integrating large-scale and complex biological and biomedical data and presenting it via knowledge graphs, together with the open access system we built for the use of researchers working on drug discovery and development. So as you all know, in this field, we are dealing with problems such as trying to understand the functions of genes and proteins, downstream effects of mutations, time-dependent dynamic molecular processes, and population-level genetic and epigenetic differences. And maybe in the last 20 years, we learned that focusing on a single gene or protein does not work when we try to understand the complex biological mechanism or occurrence of a disease related to it. And instead, different layers of this complex data should be integrated and evaluated to understand what really is going on at the molecular level and to associate it with the observed phenotype. And with different technologies becoming available to the average research lab, we now have a surge of data. And these data are organized in many different databases in different formats. And today, the number of biological and biomedical databases is in the levels of thousands. It's even quite difficult for a biological data expert to know and use all major data types and resources, let alone an average life scientist. And to answer the scientific questions we ask, it is especially crucial to study the relationships between different biological components using these vast data resources. Actually, biomolecular relationships has long been studied in the context of protein-protein interactions, gene regulatory networks, and overall signaling and metabolic pathways. However, today, the number of different types of biological data has further increased, and it's possible to take advantage of this in a larger context. And for this, we can construct multimodal or, so to say, highly heterogeneous graphs where the types of nodes and edges can change according to biological properties behind. And knowledge graphs are quite suitable to model such a system, as shown here as a toy example. And to sum up the issues, molecular properties and dynamic interactions of biomolecules must be evaluated at systems level. And to be able to develop new and effective treatment strategies and biotechnological products, it has critical importance. For this, researchers use available biological and biomedical data sources, and each one provides an important part of the knowledge. However, these sources are technically disconnected from each other, usually apart from a simple cross-referencing. As a result, there's a critical need for heterogeneous data integration. And apart from that, a closely related problem is the missing or unknown relationships. There are numerous biological associations that have not been identified yet. And an example for this can be the interactions between millions of drug candidate compounds and target biomolecules, most of them proteins. And our proposed solution to these problems is developing an open access system to annotate complex relationships and interactions between genes, proteins, pathways, systems, diseases, phenotypes, and drugs and drug candidate compounds via biological data integration, computational prediction of unknown relationships, and graph-based representation and visualization of the resulting relationship-based data. And for this, we developed CrossBar, which is a comprehensive system that integrates large-scale biomedical data from various resources, including relationships between numerous biomedical entities. And it's composed of five pillars. First one is the data integration from many resources. And the second one is the prediction of deep learning-based prediction of drug target interaction, which gets its training data from the first pillar, the database. And it produces some predicted relationships. And these relationships, together with the curated ones obtained from our source databases, are represented in knowledge graphs. And these knowledge graphs are communicated to the user, a potential user, by our web service. And for this, we built an easy-to-use web service with a graphical interface. And for the last, at different steps of the project, we did experimental validation to check the biological relevance of the system we built. Starting from the database part, data pipelines have been developed for the automated download and integration of the data from many different resources, such as UniProt, Intech, Interpro, Reactome, DrugBank, Campbell, PubChem, and disease-related resources such as Omim, Orphanet, Gene Ontology, and many more. And this database has been handled in MongoDB. And it has a publicly available API through this URL. And Crossbar database is a large-scale database as it integrates data from numerous well-known biological and biomedical databases. And actually, the data in this database serve two purposes. First of all, it constitutes the source data for the construction of knowledge graphs. And second, it provides training data for our computational predictors, which I'm going to talk about next. We have two predictive systems, each of them for drug or compounds versus target protein interaction prediction. As I said, this is a type of relationship with highest amount of missing data, and it has a critical importance for drug discovery in general. Our first system is called DeepScreen, and it utilizes two-dimensional images of compounds as its input and deep convolutional neural networks for the modeling. The second system, called MDPred, takes both compound and target features, protein features, at the input level and process them via pairwise input hybrid deep neural networks to predict the real value dose responses, such as the IC50 at the output layer. And these two systems together scan the entire compound and target spaces provided in our source databases, such as Campbell and PubChem, and identified numerous novel interacting drug or compounds against target protein pairs. Looking at these systems in a little bit more detail, DeepScreen models drug-target interaction prediction as a binary prediction problem. And each target protein has an individual prediction model. And in terms of architectures, we tried different ones, all based on convolutional neural networks, such as the Inception, AlexNet, and our in-house convolutional deep convolutional neural network, and try to find the best one. And at the output layer, the prediction is binary, such as active or inactive for the input compound against the target protein. And this system has been trained using many bioactivity results, numerous bioactivity results provided in Campbell, as separated from each other as actives and inactives according to a certain threshold. And then the model is trained with this data and optimized. When the prediction model is ready, now a compound, the image of the compound has been used and given as input to the model in inference mode, so that the model can predict its activity against the protein of interest. It's known that in silico results does not mean much without experimental validation to assess their biological relevance. And to address this problem, we carried out a series of in vitro validation experiments. Using DeepScreen, we predicted approximately 21 million interactions between 1 million compounds and 700 human proteins. And among these, the prediction of cladribine as a ligand of JAK proteins, which was completely novel, by the way, was selected for the validation experiments by our project partners in the Cancer Systems Biology Lab. I cannot go into much detail on this topic as I'm not an expert, but in vitro experiments conferred the predicted interaction on hepatocellular carcinoma cell lines, indicating the potential repositioning of this well-known drug. And further experimentation and discussion of these results may aid the ongoing work towards better understanding the molecular processes at work in liver cancers. And the second system, as I said, MDPred, actually, this is a deep chemogenomic modeling approach for drug-target interaction prediction of the target proteins with low number of training instances, so understudied targets, using pairwise input neural networks and multi-channel 2D protein features. In this work, we developed a new featurization method for proteins using their physicochemical properties and also evolutionary relationships and some sort of simple encodings in different channels. And it has been processed by the ResNet architecture together with the compound features by a multilayer perceptron. And after that, the output layer predicted the actual regression-based those values, such as IC50 values. And this system is ideal for understudied targets or even for new target discovery. Which brings me to the next part of the project, the construction of the knowledge graphs. As you know, the knowledge graph defines a specialized data representation structure in which a collection of entities as nodes are linked to each other via edges in a semantic context. And here, what you see is a crossbar knowledge graph toy example where each different colored and shaped nodes are representing a different type of biological components. For example, the genes and proteins are shown here, and the drugs are with the hexagonal shaped nodes in green color, and the compounds, drug candidate compounds, are in pink color, and the diseases are in red, obtained from different databases such as the Experimental Factor Ontology, OMIM, Orphanet, or KEK database, and they are related to each other to both the proteins, genes, and other types of components. And each edge has a different meaning, has a different type, of course. So here, this knowledge graphs is readable, semantically readable, such as, for example, the ACA2 receptor is involved in renin-angiotensin system, or fever, which is a phenotype shown here, is associated with the coronavirus infection, which is a disease. And one important thing here is that we do not keep our data as a giant knowledge graph in the system. And instead, these knowledge graphs are constructed on the fly with user queries with the name of a gene, protein, disease, drug, pathway, or phenotype, or a combination of them. At each step of the knowledge graph construction process, we control the number of nodes in the graph using hypergeometric distribution-based filtering operation. And this is a parameter that can be changed according to user requirements, of course. And here is the URL of the Crossbar web service, which has an interface something like that. This is a resulting knowledge graph for a query. Now I'm going to give two query examples. First of which is the query of trifluoroperazine, which is an antipsychotic drug, for its potential to be repurposed against gastric cancer. And this result will give us a quick evaluation on the potential of this repurposing. So using the interface, when the trifluoroperazine and gastric cancer has been searched, the resulting knowledge graphs is something like this. By the way, this layout is what we call the crossbar layout. It's a circular layout where each of the components, nodes of each component, for example, these orange ones are the core proteins, these lightly orange ones are the interacting proteins, and these blue ones are pathways, are put in a circle with a fixed radius. And the search terms, query terms are highlighted, and these networks, actually, knowledge graphs, are interactive. So the user can change the layout or move them or highlight other ones to build, in the end, article figure ready images. And in this first example, if we zoom in on the certain part of the knowledge graph, we see that the targets of the trifluoroperazine and the related genes of gastric cancer do not intersect with each other. They are different, disconnected sets. However, if you go one level up, we can see that these targets and related genes are the members of certain pathways, such as the dopaminergic synapse or calcium signaling pathway, so that the user who made this query can make some sort of evaluation for the repurposing of trifluoroperazine against gastric cancer over their sharing inside the dopaminergic synapse or calcium signaling pathways. At this step, we do not make any discussion or draw any conclusions. We left all to the expert researcher, so that the researchers can test their hypothesis or build some kind of hypothesis over some ideas, and then plan their experimental work for the later steps of their projects. So in another query example, the user queries sorafenib, regorafenib, and lenvatinib, which are all known inhibitors utilized against different types of cancer, including hepatocellular carcinoma. And this disease is a deadly subtype of liver cancer, by the way. And one of the many aims here can be the investigation of other potential drugs to be repurposed for the hepatocellular carcinoma disease. The resulting knowledge graph displays known drugs that target common core proteins given the query terms. And these core proteins are related to hepatocellular carcinoma as well, even though we did not use hepatocellular carcinoma as one of the query terms. Their relation is coming from being targets of the inhibitors of this disease. And a good candidate drug for repurposing for HCC treatment can be this drug called nintedanib, which is a small molecule kinase inhibitor with antifibrotic effects indicated for the treatment of lung diseases such as pulmonary fibrosis. So it's completely different from treating hepatocellular carcinoma. And there is a high overlap between its targets, as you see here, and core proteins associated with HCC and the targets of the non-inhibitors of hepatocellular carcinoma. It's also possible to evaluate this information in terms of high-level biological mechanisms, such as the RAP1 signaling pathway, with the observation of shared biomolecules again. The system can also be used towards drug discovery, as these pink-colored hexagons represent drug candidate compounds from the Campbell database, and their bioactivity-based relationship with these targets as blue-colored edges, and deep learning-based predicted relationships as red-colored edges. Considering multi-relations of drugs and compounds against targets and pathways, the system can be utilized for inferring both off-target effects and multi-target drug discovery, which is a topic becoming highly popular in the last decade. And in this sense, we will be extremely glad if you can use our system in your work and provide us some feedback in any way possible, including bugs and errors and potential new functionalities that could ease your work in your projects. So as a use case of the CRISPR system, we also developed curated COVID-19 knowledge graphs in two different forms, first of which is the large-scale version, which is shown here in this layout. Actually, this version is composed of more than 1,000 nodes and nearly 7,000 edges composed of human genes and proteins that is found to be directly related to coronavirus infection or human proteins that are interacting, physically interacting with the ones that has been found to be related to the coronavirus infection. And also the compounds that are known to targets and the drugs, of course, that are known to target these human genes and a few viral genes as well. And these targetings are also the approved for approved interactions and also bioactivities obtained from our source databases such as PubChem and Campbell, and also our deep learning based predictions. And also the pathways related to these human and viral genes and the diseases and phenotypes that is closely related to COVID-19 with similar implications, which provide information regarding comorbidities as well. Since this large-scale COVID-19 graph is not suitable for human inspection, this is also best for the further machine learning-based analysis or network analysis-based analysis, on this graph. We built the second one called the simplified version, and it's also composed of nearly 400 nodes and 1,000 edges, ideal for the human eye-based inspection. And the construction procedure is nearly the same. However, our starting point was the created list of human proteins provided in the UniProt database. The rest is the same. So the interactive exploration of these COVID-19 knowledge graphs can be for to observe direct or indirect relationships to build hypotheses in terms of this infectious disease mechanism, and also for the treatment strategies by following the relationships of the virus genes, proteins, and human proteins, their direct interactions, and also the physical interactions between those related human genes and their targeting drugs and drug candidate compounds, and also the high-level pathways so that the new hypothesis can be built. And using this system, we predicted some drugs, inhibitor drugs for against COVID-19, just of course to mild down the symptoms of the severe cases of patients. So using this overrepresentation analysis and our predictors such as deep screen and also MDPRET, we have made many predictions and we wanted to validate them based on the literature. And we have seen that most of these predictions has already been gone into clinical trials at different phases, which tells us our predictions are at least biologically relevant. Now, some of these drugs has passed these clinical trial stages as well. Now, these are the project-related resources and the publications that came along the way. For those of you who are interested to get more detailed information, and this is the umbrella prediction that came out a few months ago. And these are our project-related, system-related resources, URLs. Also, the CROSSBAR system has been gone into the European COVID-19 data platform as a related tool. And now at the end of this point, I want to thank my project collaborators, starting from the UK team, UniProt database team leader Maria Martin, and the wonderful bioinformaticians and system developers working in the team, and also our Turkish team composed of two universities, Middle East Technical University and Hacettepe University, and starting from the other project leaders, Dr. Volkan Atalay and Dr. Rengül Çetin Atalay, and Dr. Ahmet Rifaioğlu, who did the work related to the deep learning-based predictors, development of all of them, and also Heval Ataş, my PhD student, who worked on the knowledge graphs, and Ahmet Atakan, who worked on the web service, the interface, and the backend developments, and also the Esra Nalbat, who worked on the experimental validation parts as well. And now we are working on the second version of the CROSSBAR project with national level funding. Here we are incorporating new types of biological components, such as cells, tissues, patient records, organisms, especially for host pathogen relationships, function defining ontological systems such as gene ontology or EC numbers, and sequence and structural signatures such as domains, motifs, and repeats. We are also adding new types of relationships such as cell disease, patient disease, or cell gene and patient gene in the context of gene expression profiles and mutations and other types as well. And the main aim here is to shift the focus more on precision medicine. And here you see the newly added nodes and newly added types of relationships shown in red color, and existing ones are shown in gray color. It is also time for us to practice artificial learning directly on these enriched knowledge graphs in order to predict unknown relationships between different types of components. For this, we are applying graph representation learning algorithms such as neural message passing. And graph neural networks combines the advantages of feature-based machine learning methods and solely relationship-based network analysis methods by propagating the latent node features across the edges of the graph, one step at each hidden layer. A similar approach has recently been applied on drug-target interaction graphs to predict a few different types of relationships, such as the polypharmacy-related side effects, as in this study. In our approach, we have highly heterogeneous graphs, so the architectures should be intensively modified to leverage this information. We are working on this at the moment. In this system, we have an encoder and decoder module, and as input, we use CROSSBAR knowledge graphs for relationship information and term-specific feature vectors for initial node and edge encodings. The encoder learns complex relationship between each biological component type, and the decoder transforms the intermediate representations of node pairs to probabilities of the predicted relationship between these two nodes, such as a gene and a disease. Other predicted relationships will be the drug against disease, protein against function, and drug against target protein. So this model, going back to my previous slide, this model predicts edges between nodes that are far away from each other on the graph, like, for example, this cell and this compound, based on their intrinsic properties and shared neighborhoods on the knowledge graph. We also plan to incorporate interpretability yielding modules such as the attention module, so that any relationship prediction will have an associated node and edges which play critical roles for the predicted association. The last but not the least, I would like to thank all my group members at the Biological Data Analysis Lab at Hacettepe University Department of Computer Science and AI Engineering and Middle East Technical University Informatics Institute. Without their effort, any piece of this work would not be possible. And before finishing my presentation, I want to mention that we are also eager to collaborate with other research groups and especially with pharmaceutical companies to further develop the crossbar system and turn it into a product that can be utilized in real drug discovery and repurposing pipelines. So if you're interested, please contact me on social media or via email. Thank you for your interest.
Hey, thank you, Tunka, for a very, very interesting talk and showing us about your system and the developments you've been doing within the knowledge graph field.
Thank you very much.